In this tutorial, I will show you how to make a professional Discord server similar to mine. This is going to be a long video, so strap in. The first step when it comes to making a Discord server is to obviously create the server itself. Do you see this little add a server button right here? I want you to go ahead and click on that one. There should be four options. Just go for the first one, create my own. You can just skip this. Name your server. I'll just call this one Stax's second server. And I will upload my icon right now. You can do this later, it doesn't matter. I will make my icon that and click on create. Please note that you don't have to make the server from scratch if you don't want to. You can always just use a template. A good place to find templates is discords.com, which is today's sponsor. Go to discords.com, click on templates, select the template that you want to use. I will go for local communities, use, new server. Wait till this loads, return to your Discord, name your server, and add the icon if you would like, and click on create. Now you don't have to worry about setting up text channels, reaction roles, and more. Let's get back to creating the other server from scratch if that's the way you're going to go. When a Discord server is created, Discord automatically makes one voice channel and one text channel for you. What we're going to first do is rename that category. Well, let's just name it, I guess, General. Just do General for now. That'll be okay. We can change that later. This can remain voice channels. Let's add a couple more channels. Let's add like a media channel, commands, etc. I think this is good enough. What we're going to do next is actually enable the community feature. So go to Server Settings, scroll down, Enable Community, and click on Get Started. Keep your community safe, make sure every member that joins has a verified email, and scan media content from all members, and this will exclude not safe for work channels. Click on next, just leave these as create one for me. One last step, set default notifications to mentions only, and remove moderation permissions from everybody, and by setting your server as community server, you agree that your server complies with the community guidelines. Just click on I agree and understand, because I know for a fact you're not going to read the community guidelines. It's okay, I have not read them either, and click on finish setup. Discord will automatically create two new channels for you, rules and moderator only, and there's a new message. This channel has been set up to receive... What we will do now is quickly create a information category, which is where the rules, announcements, and maybe an uploads channel if you're a YouTuber will go. So let's just drag the rules channel into there and sync its permissions with the category. I'll just leave that there for now. Let's add a couple more channels like announcements, information. And I guess let's do an uploads channel just for the sake of it. This is going to be a very, very quick second part, and it is decoration. You can add emojis to the channel names like this. I wouldn't. It looks a little too over-decorated. If you want to do it, go for it. Just don't over-decorate it. What I would recommend doing is adding emojis to the category names like this. I'm just going to quickly do that for all the other categories. And just like that, that looks way better. You might think that we're probably done now, but look at this. I don't have any roles. That's because we haven't created any. Let's make some roles. Go to your server settings, roles, create role. Let's just make an owner role for now. Owner, let's set the color. You can choose whatever color you want. I will do like a, what looks good? I like that blue. Let's do that. Be sure to display this role separately from online members. And we will just give it administrator for now, because basically you're going to be the only one that has it. Now that you have created the owner role, give it to yourself by clicking on your username, tapping on the plus icon below no roles, and then clicking on owner. Your username will now appear the color that you chose your role. Now that we have the owner role set up, let's make three more roles. Staff. A member role, and finally a bot role. This one does not have to have any color, but still make it separate from online members. Now that you have a staff role created, let's make a staff category. We'll just name it staff, make it a private category, just hit skip and drag the moderator only channel into here and sync its permissions. Let me just add some emojis to that just to make it look a little better.
before we move on to the fourth step, let's just add some permissions to some of these channels, like the information channel, where only people who have like admin perms can send messages. So go to the category settings, permissions, add everyone, scroll down until you see send messages, and hit the X. Just like that. Let's just make it to where people cannot send any files in general chat. So go to the permissions, add everyone, attach files, just like that. Hit save changes. Let's also make it to where they cannot manage the server. Like they can't manage the channel, the permissions, the webhooks, embed links, mention add everyone, manage messages. Let's just save the changes there and quickly make that into the general category. Now that we have the permission set up for every channel, let's add some bots. Bots I would recommend adding are V6, which has a very good moderation system. Make sure that all these permissions are checked because they are required for the bot to work properly. Dino, which has a good moderation system. Carlbot, which has very good reaction roles. Be sure to keep this page open just for now. We will configure the bot a little later. Wickbot, which can make your server more secure. Rhythm, which allows members to play music in voice channels. Dankmemer, which is known for its economy system. And finally, Atlas, which is what we will use for leveling system. Since we still have the Carlbot page open, or I hope, let's just configure it. Click on get started, add a custom prefix. You can keep them at question mark or exclamation mark. I'm gonna make it a star or an asterisk. None, reaction role templates. I would recommend colors, pronouns, and probably that's it. And just for the sake of it, I'm gonna do zodiac signs. If you go back onto your Discord server, you will notice that Carl created a channel called Get Roles, which shows all of the reaction roles that we just set up. Just drag that into the information category and sync the permissions. Just to prove that they work, I will just quickly test them out. Color roles, let's do purple just for the sake of it. That's not going to show though. What is your zodiac sign? I am a Scorpion. And just like that, they are working, just like that. And if we were to unreact, Carlbot will remove them. Hit next. What channel should the mod logs be posted in? We'll just skip that for now. Set up automated moderation. Just keep that as off, and then we are good enough. We'll configure the bot a little more just in a bit, but let's quickly configure Wickbot. So go to its page, which is wickbot.com. You can close this. Dashboard. Select your server. Scroll down and let's go to Join Gate and click on Configure. What we will first do is make sure that Wick kicks every member who does not have an avatar, kick members whose accounts are less than a week old, and kick members that seem suspicious. We can go back to the dashboard and let's quickly set up a verification system by clicking on Verification and Configure. We will make the mode that the action. I want Wick to quarantine accounts that fail the verification. We will quickly set up the quarantine role in just a bit. Duration, give it 2 minutes. Targets, I want Wick to verify all accounts joining. Now let's move back onto Discord and fully set up Wick. Just so Wick is able to set up properly, I forgot to mention that I created two new channels, staff chat and staff commands. Just go to the staff commands and write W exclamation mark setup. Create the channels first, obviously. You probably noticed that Wick created two new channels, mod logs and Wick logs. Just drag those into the staff category and sync the permissions. One thing I forgot to do was actually enable the verification system. So just to prove that it works, here's me joining that exact server on an alt.
Feels like a test.
test that I fail so depressed.
A great way for your members to stay active is by having a leveling system in your server. Create a few leveling roles, like I'll just do a few simple ones like level 5, level 10, level 25. So this will be our level 5.
Level 10, level 3.
Be sure to drag these roles higher than the reaction roles, but just below the bot roles. Now let's actually set up the leveling system. So go to atlasbot.xyz or xyz, if that's how you say it, if you're one of my American audiences, which I believe half of you are. Stacks a second server. Be sure to enable the leveling roles just like this. Let's just add an award. Where is it? Be sure to drag Atlas's role above the level roles so it can hand it out to members. You can change up the notification to how Atlas is going to announce that you leveled up. You can make it to where they DM it instead. But just leave it for now for default. You can change this up later. I'm just going to make it simple. And we are almost done. We just have a few more things to do, so let's get on to the final parts of the video. I should have done this at the very beginning of the video, but there's one thing I never added. Rules. I never ever added server rules. Common rules in servers include no NSFW, no advertising, no memes in general, English only. There's many of them. Make your own rules. Be creative. Don't just copy off of me here. Same goes with the information. The information category is like different in almost every server I've been in. Some of them don't even have an information channel. But typically they will list like obtainable roles, the perks, the leveling system roles, which you should definitely add. Just be creative with that as well. The staff list and more stuff. I'm not going to go into detail. Here's a video you can watch that will actually probably help you out very well if you want very good looking information channels. But anyways, another thing we never added are emojis. We never added emojis. We have to do that. Go to discords.com or any emoji list, or even make your own emojis, but I'm going to use discords.com's emoji list. And look at that, they have emoji packs. Let's do the Minecraft ones. Let's do the Pepe ones. Maybe favorites. Trending emotes, we'll do this LOL Keck Poggers. I guess I'll do the F-boy one. Go back to your Discord, upload the emojis to your computer just like this. I'm just gonna have to quickly unzip those other packages so I can get to the other ones. Okay, I have unzipped and extracted all of the emojis, so I'm just gonna quickly drag them in here and add them to the server. And just like that, we now have emojis and also animated ones. You can make your very own. The amount of emojis you can have in a server go up depending on how much the server has been boosted. I believe it is 50 for just a regular server, 100 for a level 1 boosted, 150 I think for maybe 200. I do not remember. I will add it on the screen, the correct number. For a level 2 server, and a level 3 server is 250. And this one, you're going to have at least a level 1 boosted server to access this. Stickers. So I'm completely unable to add the stickers anywhere. A good place to find stickers as well is, of course, the one and only. You're probably now wondering, where the heck can I put this out so people can join? There are plenty of places you can go. You can go to discord.org, discords.com, many, many places. I'm just going to do discords.com just for the sake of it. So I'm going to quickly add the server, add the bot very quickly. And okay, we need to first do is server name. That's what we'll do. Primary language, show in the public list, select role, remove roles after. Yeah. Short description. This server sucks. Don't join it. Long description? I know exactly what we'll do. Lorem ipsum dolus sitemet can sectator. This is getting super damn cringy. Next. Keywords, we'll just do stacks, YouTube. I guess that's enough. That one's optional. Just like that, it has been added, and Yeah. If you want more members that are active, buy their premium option. Premium is $9.99 a month. That's probably in US dollars. Gain an average of 2,360 members each month. Featured on your front page, pinned on all tags and listing, pink and blurple server accents, exclusive Discord roles and channel, a premium badge, and support our development. And then the advanced, which is $14.99 a month. That's in US probably. Gain an average of 3,100 members a month. Everything from original premium, featured 75% more often, red server accents, exclusive Discord roles and channels, premium badge, and support our development. Anyways, that is going to wrap up today's video. If you enjoyed it, please hit the subscribe button. Maybe join my Discord server, follow my Twitter, follow my Twitch, follow my Reddit. I have too many freaking social media accounts, and goodbye.